Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the previous parts we cleared out the towers for level 8, so I was thinking about moving on to level 9, but I did a little reading up and there's actually a couple of monsters in level 8 that have some items that are kind of worth looting, or at least, yeah, like the wyverns for example, a couple other ones as well. And also, I kind of want to get my fighter experience up a little bit, because it's lagging behind pretty badly, and I'd like to get one or two more fighter levels in before we get to the end. Just to get some more experience, or some more hit points, and some better stats, of course. We're pretty good on our wizard experience for the moment, so I'd like to get some more fighter experience in as well. Now to do that, if you remember from the previous parts, these monsters are getting a little bit too strong for us to just run into and kill with our melee weapons. So really the only way to get them is to use some items that'll help us kill them more easily. Now we could use a demon's ring, of course, to make ourselves more or less invincible and invisible as well. But since this level is so open and there's a lot of monsters clumped up in the same areas, I think instead I will be using an hourglass. Hourglasses, if you remember from one of the previous videos, will freeze the monsters in place and make it so that we can just hit them without the fear of being retaliated against. It will also last a little while, so once we activate it, as you could see just now, we have 46 time. Exactly what this translates to in game is a little bit vague, but it means we'll be able to kill a bunch of monsters with a single item, and with any luck we'll be able to loot some better items for our trouble, as well as getting our experience up. Now if you remember, these wyverns are extremely strong, so the fact that we can just walk up to them and kill them now without taking any damage at all is pretty good. One thing to keep in mind when you're using items is, as long as you're moving around outside, your time runs out, but as soon as you get into combat, for game purposes, the time freezes. So as long as you're in a fighting screen like I am now, your food doesn't run out, your items don't run out, so I could stay here for as long as I like basically. But as soon as I kill this guy, the time starts running again. So as soon as I kill him, I want to get out of there as quickly as possible and find something else to kill, just to optimize the time I spent using this hourglass. One thing about hourglasses is monsters don't respawn while the hourglass is active, so you have to be you won't be able to kill two or three of the same spawn in a row with one hourglass the same way you could with a demon's ring, for example. I'll show you the demon's ring approach in a little bit, maybe in the next level, because I think the demon's ring is going to be more useful on level 9. Have to be a little bit careful, because I think one of these guys are poison guys, although I'm not really sure which one. Let me check my notes real quick. Yeah, these guys are poisonous sometimes, so I have to be a little bit careful. Camzolts can be poisonous. What else? I think that's it. Yeah, camzolts and shamblings. So we have to be a little bit careful with these guys, but obviously this one is dropping gold, so we don't have to be careful at all. Again, 2000 a pop, very nice. Oh, and as you could see, the monster started moving again and also started respawning again, so our hourglass ran out there. Might be wise to take a quick look at how many we have. Of course, we already looted one from the, what was it? The wyvern, I think. So we already got one back. Yeah, we have 22 of these and only 18 demon's rings, so we're better stocked with these hourglasses than we are with the demon's rings anyway. I could have gotten this one probably. Oh well. Let's find a place where they're kind of clumped together so we can optimize our hourglass usage. Actually, maybe this is okay. I can just kill these two. And of course, every time we use the hourglass, we end up getting a little bit more time. Eventually you'll be able to kill quite a lot of monsters with just a single hourglass. There we go, and as you can see, all these guys give us a lot of experience. Our fighter experience is now already up to 400,000. So definitely worth it. This is really where our hoarding of the items from the earlier levels starts paying off. As I said before, the reason I don't use them in the earlier levels is because, first of all, we took a very low wisdom early on, so they wouldn't have been very useful. And second, because the early levels are pretty easy anyway. In the later levels, this wouldn't be possible without using an hourglass or a demon's ring. Okay, brown potion. Not really worth it, but we're doing this for the experience. Not so much for the items. Although any nice items are going to be welcome, of course. Again, 2000 experience for every kill, so that's pretty nice. I think this... Come on, open up. Ah. Thank God it was a balance. Oops, time ran out. Let's see if we can find some more critters up here somewhere. I guess these will do. I'd really like to find another wyvern instead of these guys. But I guess two Kamzotzes and a Shambling are sort of worth it at least. Another balance. I think the next one is poison, so we have to be a little bit careful. You also have to not move like a spaz like I did just now. Waste a lot of time. Gonna get on this side of him so I can get out very quickly. I think this is the poison one, so one more balance. I guess the next one will be poison then. These guys as well. So yeah, this is just really a very quick and easy way to get your fighter level up to speed after ignoring it a bit in the previous levels. Here we go, that was the poison one. Oops, let's get this one. As you can see, freezing them with the hourglass also gives you the ability to instant hit anything. I believe it just reduces their agility to zero or something, because normally it takes a little while to get a hit in, and now we're just popping them very easily. So the hourglass, definitely one of the most powerful items in the game, I'd say. Isn't there any more monsters up here? I thought so. But probably the hourglass ran out. No, it didn't yet. Ah, the wyvern. This is the guy I was looking for. The wyverns have the best items for this level, in my opinion anyway. First of all, they drop hourglasses, and in the final spawn, they actually drop an elixir as well. So, very, very nice. Oops, timer ran out again. Wait, let me check these guys. Are these worth it? Memphis Bana. Not particularly. I'll just use my magic on this guy. Might be able to hit him from the side. Nope. Jesus. Okay, so that was a bad idea. We'll go back to the tried and true hourglass method. See, we've already doubled the time the hourglass lasts compared to the first one we used. Just because our experience is getting higher. There we go. I think we have one more of those poison guys running around somewhere. Oh wait, these guys never drop poison, I don't have to be careful. Give me one more. There we go. Oh, this is the gold one, okay. Can I get this one as well? Yeah, I think so. Very nice. 2200 experience per pop. Pretty sure this is the poison one, so I have to be a little bit careful. You know what? Let's not take any chances. I'll just magic the last one. It's either poison or a balance, so we're not really losing anything of value. One more? Yeah, very nice. Clearly, after a couple of uses, these hourglasses last a long time, so we can easily just wipe them out. I think these are demon's rings, right? Hoping it's not poison. Yeah. Oh, the wyvern, the wyvern, the wyvern. Yeah. Not the best experience, but definitely the best items. And as you can see, the experience with our Giant Slayer is also already getting pretty nice. We're doing in excess of 120,000 damage per hit. So it's worth it for the weapon experience as well as the character experience. The only downside is you do not train your armor this way, but if training your armor means taking massive amounts of damage, I'd say that's worth it. I'm guessing we'll use maybe one, two more hourglasses in this level, and then we'll be pretty much done. Mostly I want to get these wyvern guys, but I want to freeze time somewhere where I can get at them. If he's somewhere up on the roof and I use my hourglass, I won't be able to find to get him unless I use, you know, wing boots or something. Actually, I think we might be coming up on our time limit. I forgot to set the timer again. So I will just kill a couple more monsters and then we will stop and I will move on to the next part. Come on, critters, where are you? I want a couple more kills. There we go. I'm pretty sure this is the poison one for this spawn, but I'm not convinced, so let's have a look. Nope, the next one. Oops. Mostly what I'm still looking for is the last two wyvern spawns. After that, I'll be pretty much ready to move on to level 9. It's really the wyverns you want in this level. Although, of course, any experience is good experience. Oh, and the Kamzotzes, of course. Kinda glad I managed to get this one in here. The Kamzotzes are also a prime target because, I will show you right now, they drop mushrooms, which, as you remember from the earlier towers, will increase your health, or your maximum health, I should say. So they are also very nice. Okay guys, I really think we're coming up on the time limit, so I'm going to cut off the video here, and I will see you in the next part, when we'll probably be ready to move on to level 9. Okay guys, thanks for watching, and see you then.